What if bears lived in groups? Dangerous and terrifying animals are found all over the world. Lions, they live in a pride, many of them together stalking their prey. Wolves, they live and hunt in a pack, using their sheer numbers to take down large animals. And then there are bears. Terrifying, yes, dangerous, of course, but they lead generally solitary lives. But what if bears lived in groups like many other animals that we know of? How different would things be? And would they change the landscape drastically? What would that mean for the rest of us? Might another animal species be in danger of losing habitat or going extinct? Bears. There are bears all over this planet. 8 different species of bears, to be exact. In Asia, you have sloth bears, sun bears, Asian black bears, and panda bears. Found in the polar region is, of course, the polar bear. In South America is the spectacled bear. Only in North America is the American black bear, and then the one everyone thinks of when you simply say bear, the brown bear. In North America, Europe, Russia, he's all over. But all of these bears live solitary lives, with the exception of during mating season and when you have mothers with their cubs. The rest of the time, the bear mainly lives alone, eats alone, and hunts alone. Now, each bear is different, but many of them live primarily off plants. The polar bear is an exception. There isn't much vegetation up there in the frigid ice. But even brown bears, enormous as they are, have about 90% of their diet coming from plants and fruits. Yes, they hunt for fish, for rodents, and occasionally larger animals too. But they get by primarily on plants, and they have no problem feeding themselves, seeing as how they can easily get over 1,000 pounds. Animals in groups. We mentioned some other animals that live in groups. Skilled hunters like lions and wolves. These are carnivores who don't just live and hunt together, they need to. If a wolf wants to take down a deer for dinner, he will need the rest of his buddies in the pack to bring down the enormous animal. It's the same with lions going after a zebra or a wildebeest or possibly a Cape buffalo. It will be far easier if there are several of them attacking at once. And these animals that live in groups go for large animals because they need a lot of meat to feed the whole family. Bears rarely go after large animals because they're alone. They don't need that much food. That's why rodents will often suffice for a huge brown bear. If a lion were alone, he may be able to get by on occasional rodents here and there. But he isn't alone. He's got the whole pride to think of. That's why they need that big zebra. It's not just because everyone has their preference for white meat and dark meat, and the zebra satisfies them all. It's because there is just so much meat on the bone. So, what if bears lived in a similar group? Putting bears in groups. So, let's put our bears in groups, something similar to wolves and lions. Let's say the group is somewhere between 6 to 10 individuals. Now, every good group needs a particular hierarchy. So the largest male in the group is likely going to be the leader. Maybe they're like lions and the males form a coalition. Say it's 4 of them, and then they have the 6 females that help round out their group. Or they could be like wolves and have a dominant pair, male and female, and everyone else falls in line behind them. When it comes to wolves, only the dominant pair mates and no one else does. If you look at a gorilla troop, the male gorilla that is the boss will mate with any and all of the adult female gorillas, and the other males don't. However, when you look at a lion pride, it could be more than just one of the male lions who breeds. So, which path does it seem like bears would take? Let's take brown bears, for instance. When 2 male brown bears both want to mate with a female, they fight, standing up on their hind legs, roaring at one another, and clashing until one can be declared the victor. And once the male bear begins to court the female, the two are inseparable for days. This makes it hard to imagine the bear going the way of the gorilla and allowing himself 4, 5, or even 6 mates. He is protective of his female, so no one else can have her. Would another male and female bear be allowed to mate in the group? Much like lions, perhaps. Looking at black bears and polar bears and all the other species, it feels they'd behave similarly, allowing one dominant mating pair like wolves, or maybe allowing 2 males to mate like the lions do. But there would absolutely be a dominant male bear in the group who leads everyone. He'd call the shots, pick out their home base, and he'd lead them on excursions for food. However, looking for food is now going to be vastly different. One bear used to only worry about himself. If he found a few bushes with some great berries to eat, perfect. If he found a few other plants, then he would be in business. He'd satiate his hunger easily enough. But a few berry bushes won't cut it for this bear and his group of 9 others. So, how is he going to change things up to make sure that everyone eats? What do they do for food? Aside from polar bears, most bears have a diet mainly of plants. 90% plants for the brown bear. This won't cut it for our groups of 10 bears. They'd have to resort to eating much more meat. Remember our brown bears who got by on occasional rodents and only very rarely went after larger animals? Well, now they'd be fixated on those larger ungulates. Deer, elk, moose, maybe even bison if they came across them. Those would be prime targets. Our lead brown bear would know. His stomach was rumbling, and there were 9 other rumbling stomachs in the group behind him. Brown bears share habitats with many deer, elk, and moose, so they'd seek them out, developing a strategy close to what lions do. Wolves are endurance hunters, able to keep up fast speeds for long distances, tiring out their prey. The bear can hit fast speeds, but only briefly, much like a lion. So they'd have to become expert ambush predators. A brown bear can hit speeds of 35 miles per hour, but a deer can hit anywhere from 35 to 50, so our group of bears would need to sneak through the forests, staying hidden and camouflaged among the trees. Once they were close enough, they could jump into action. There's many of them, so they could attack from different directions. One bear could flank the deer from one side and lead it into the direction of another bear. The deer may be faster, but if it needs to constantly change directions to avoid the many bears in the group, it would allow others to run in a straight line from behind and tackle him. Once the deer is down, it's just a matter of time before it's all over, probably even seconds. American black bears would develop similar habits, being slightly smaller than brown bears, and being able to hit speeds of 30 miles per hour in short bursts. As brown bears may often opt for moose, black bears might aim for the deer more often. A polar bear's eating habits wouldn't change, but the hunt would be easier with a group of them going after seals and walruses. Asian black bears would behave similarly to American black bears, targeting the animals of the Cervidae family in Asia, perhaps Chinese water deer, sika deer, and goral. The panda bear could go after many of the same animals in the Cervidae family if they wanted to. Pandas do have a system that more closely resembles that of a carnivore, more so than any other bear, but they eat about 99% bamboo. There might be enough bamboo in China for our group of panda bears, but if they ran out, they might start competing with the Asian black bears for larger mammals, as they do occasionally already eat rodents. Now we come to some of the smaller bears. Sun bears and sloth bears live in Southeast Asia, and they're smaller than most of the rest of the bears. Sloth bears should have no problem with this adaptation. They're already vicious, have long nails, and have been known to attack tigers. If one sloth bear can attack a tiger, then 10 of them will go wild, taking down all the hog deer, black bucks, gorals. They might even attempt to take down some water buffalo. Now, sun bears are less vicious, and they already love spending time in the trees and pulling out insects to eat. They'll go after birds and rodents, and seeing as how they're the smallest of all bears, they might not need to change up their diet too much. Lastly, we have spectacled bears in South America. Small rodents and birds won't cut it for a family of 10. They'll start competing with the jaguars and cougars, going after pampas deer, brocket deer, and even 300-pound-plus marsh deer. Now imagine this. All these bear species have gone from their diet being about 10% meat to far more due to the size of their group. They may be eating 50% meat at this point, but as their need for meat has increased already, it will increase more so they can continue to feed themselves. It might wind up making up 70% of their diet, even 80%, and then what happens? What does this mean for other animals? Think about it. Different environments have a certain balance. That's how they continue on the way they do. Bears hunting in groups, this becomes a disruption. Take North America, for example. You had black bears living solo, occasionally hunting animals. You had brown bears doing the same thing. You have predators like wolves hunting in packs, cougars that hunt alone, even the lynx as well. Now that the bears live in big groups and need more meat, They are competing with the other predators. First off, there was balance. One brown bear, a pack of wolves, that matchup could go either way. The two parties tend to know to keep away from one another. But now you have a pack of wolves and a group of brown bears. Just as many, all far larger in size. The wolves stand no chance. The wolves will find separate areas to hunt, but the brown bears have become dominant apex predators. But all the deer, elk, moose, they'll all be in critical danger. Their numbers will deplete rapidly as they still worry about wolves and cougars, but now also two types of bear. You could see the numbers of these animals dwindle significantly. Who knows if they'd even approach extinction? Or would wolves suffer as their food source is depleting and the bears are hogging all of it? Similar situations could happen across Asia. The black bears there, the sloth bears, they'd be taking down plenty of the animals in the cervidae family. Those numbers could drop significantly. And no longer do tigers feel like the top dog, the apex predator. If there is a group of bears in the area, that entity is the new undisputed apex predator. There's not even a question. The spectacled bears would give jaguars and cougars a run for their money in South America. Once again, depleting the numbers of cervidae as they look to fill their appetites with food other than plants. In this scenario, bears are the new undisputed apex predators on land. No other animals can stop a group of 10 bears, especially the brown bears. They're too massive. As time went on and they dominated their habitats even more, the situation could get even more out of hand. With no predators to kill the bears, their numbers would explode. Places could be overrun with bears. And then, what does this mean for the humans? Where do the humans stand? Major cities should remain the same, but think about areas with lower populations, more remote areas. The populations of bears would increase over time. You'd have more instances of bears encroaching upon humans' habitats, and that spells trouble. Areas that were formerly considered livable by humans, they may not be anymore. Remote areas in Canada, Alaska, Russia, and places like that would see people having to vacate and move closer to civilization. Even smaller towns would be living with the constant worry of the danger of the groups of bears. Hey, who's to say bears wouldn't develop a taste for human flesh? We're lucky and should thank the stars that bears are solitary creatures. There's a natural order to things, and though they are apex predators most times in their environments, they have other apex predators to compete with. They aren't unstoppable. If bears began to live in groups, they'd become nearly invincible. Most of them, especially the brown bears and black bears, they'd be the absolute dominant species in their habitat, hands down. With nothing to check them, their populations would get out of control, and they'd take over areas, driving away other predators. Other predators would suffer. The wolves, the cougars, even the tigers. The numbers of prey animals would drop significantly, and humans would have to start watching their backs. It would be as scary as living near a known lion habitat in Africa. There are areas in Africa that people just don't live because the lions own those parts. We'd be seeing a lot more places like that all over the world, in Asia, in Europe, in North America, because it could turn into a planet of invincible bears.